And we're back with another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Let's get the frag out of here. I think I can head anywhere and head out of here, right? Of the city, I mean. Hold up. Let's go faster. We finally finished all our various quests. Well, the ones I can think of anyway, in the city. The rest of the quests are to be done outside somewhere. World map, yes. Look at a Madmere Bridge and talk to these people. That's how long it would take. Just across the city. 2 days. That's crazy. 2 days, here we go. Have you ever traveled that long in one bit? I mean, maybe we're going to be exhausted by the time we get out there. Well, the Bailey construction is completed. Nevri the Deft Hand. Alright, let's... Let's send Sagani this time to escort him away. A wanted criminal. All right. This is the stuff we have left. This is what I want to do. I want to get the barracks so I can employ hirelings. I'm not sure if I can employ the hirelings from the menu or I have to go back. You must be at the stronghold to recruit or dismiss party members. You must build the... This is the hirelings tab. Okay. Good to know. Alright. Now these people... Forget, we found out who they were. I think we did. Oh, come on, we can't even talk to them. Maybe it wasn't them. Okay, never mind. Maybe I was confused by something. I don't know. So... Anslog's compass. We have something to do there. An actual quest this time.
We'll fare better if we get some sleep.
Oh, I haven't been to Anslog's compass? I thought I have. There's people here. Edrang and Tilly. What's the quest we have to do here? None of those. Meet Aranroed by the dock. Be waiting for the research for Commander Cleaver. Okay. Well, it seems silly to just camp here when there's people just standing here. Let's talk to them or see about them or something. Two villagers stand by one of the tide pools. They are breathing harshly, clearly winded, and look up nervously as you approach.
Well met, friend.
If you're here to fish like us, you'll want to avoid the compass proper. The dwarven woman points to the southeast. There are some suspicious folk down there. Her companion shakes his head. Thought they were going to try something, the way they were looking at us. Not as if we've got anything to our names but fishing nets. What's this compass? Oh, it's the rock down there to the southeast. The formation, I mean. Someone figured it looked like a little like a sundial, you know? I don't really see it. Edrang says, not a good place for sailing. You'll see plenty of wrecks along the coast, but the fishing's good. So what are you two doing out here? Tilly says, well, fishing, of course. We were, anyway. Not much to be had up here in these little tide pools. We'll wait a while, see if those folks leave anytime soon. You mentioned suspicious people? Yes, sir. Not sure what they're up to, nor did we go asking questions. Looks like they just landed on the shore. Andrang says, none of our business anyway. We're only here to get ourselves some dinner, and then we're heading straight home. All right, fare thee well. Good tidings to you. Wait, did you hear that? Uh-oh. What do we hear? Oh, a Zorap. At least one. There must be more. It's going to take a while for them to load. Things are already running. Let's just attack it. Oh, there's a bunch. Let's hope it doesn't kill these guys. Since there's three, let's pull out the stops. I want to see that in action. I don't want to hit these guys by mistake, though, with it. Wasn't Durance here? Yeah. God, what a mess! Thank you for your help, stranger. Anytime. Oh, this theme.
Of course.
Alright, they're just leaving. I'd be willing to heal them. But I don't think we can.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Yeah, that was kind of a mess. Excuse me.
Yeah.
I think we could stand to look around.
Yeah.
I know we're tired. We've traveled far, but... such a mournful tune. Crabs and small fish cluster in this pool, left behind by the tide. More. Oh my god. See, it's not even worth doing anything but just slashing them. In the easy area so far.
Let's see what lies this way.
Yes, let's. Ooh, what's this? Like a little puddle of water or something? We're walking all over the frickin' thing, not that I even mean to. In the sand is an agate. Agates are common on Eora, oft used by craftsmen for their bright colors. Their considerable hardness also lends them a variety of more practical applications. I don't remember coming across an agate before. So I read the description. Page from Fulvano's Travels. Hey, we got a bunch of your stuff. Gotta say, good stuff. After several days' journey, it seems it is time to at last to part ways with my traveling companion from New Haymar. A pity we could not see the compass together, but perhaps we will have as grand a time in Jiren's grasp. I have given him my gloves for safekeeping, for I will hardly need them in such fine weather. Your gloves, huh? These gloves? This looks foreboding. Can't even look at these things. What do they say? Southwest? I think that's where we're gonna be. Ranga and Tana. Hail! Hail to thee! What's in this? Fish and clumps of seaweed, bright green with heat, royal in the stew. It tastes pleasantly salty. Well, hello, Ranga. You find yourself facing a towering Aumaua woman. Her skin is the warm gold brown of a dying sunset, with pale fish-white patches at her throat and hands, wavy red-brown hair pulled into tight braids around a stripe of bare skin that follows the curve of her skull, flows down over her broad shoulders.
How do you do?
She regards you calmly, evidently unsurprised to find you here at the edge of her camp by the water. Have you come for medicines and craftworks, or to share the fire? She gestures to the large cauldron nearby. Well, I think it would be you sharing the fire, then. That's much appreciated. Who are you? My name is Ranga. I lived in Gilded Vale a time, working as a healer and a midwife. Perhaps you've been to that place? You'll understand, then, why I might choose to come south. Ranga, is it? Kanna chuckles. And what are you Ranga Nui of, cousin? Why not sail north and join us in Rorotai? Is that where you found that accent, Islander? Ranga smirks. Keep your Rorotai. I would sooner be king of this little island. More of a little peninsula, I'd say. That's cool. Actually, something one of your companions says that the person you meet responds to. What's that Zorup doing here? Who, Tana? He helps me gather ingredients, work the cauldron, things like that. He's been quite a help around here. The Zorup lets out a rattling chirrup and bares its teeth in what you guess is intended to be a cheerful expression. Cute. Afra sent me here. She says that you know some way to ensure that her child is not a hollowborn. Ah. More of Lord Radric's frightened flock, she nods slowly. You are kind to come all this way. Poor Afra must be beside herself. I imagine she gave you something for payment? Whatever it is, you keep it. I don't need coin. I need you to do something for me instead. Ranga points inland. There is a Zorup tribe to the northeast, led by one of their priests. Tana was exiled from there some time ago, and their scouts still lurk about this place, waiting for an opportunity to end his life. The Zorup lets out a rattling squawk, head drooping. One day I will have to go for supplies. Then I will come back to find my assistant slain. How will I help anyone then? She shakes her head. You rid me of this nuisance, and I will do what I can for Afra. And throw in something for you, too. All right. I'll be back when it's done. Good, good. You'll find them easily enough, I think, she smiles, baring sharp teeth. Good luck. So this is something else in Anslog's compass that I forgot about, I guess. Yeah, he's right. It is more of a peninsula. To the northeast.
Light, flame, and sound.
We'll keep to ourselves.
Another Zorup. Boom.
Yeah.
You go boom now. Got rid of one. Is it even worth the effort of trading our weapon sets back and forth?
Of course.
Oh, it's dead already. What do you say? Two amethysts?
Yep. Close your eyes, Watcher. Not all of us are on such bad terms with sleep.
Huh. They really want to rest, don't they? Alright, guys.
Sure.
I pray you won't mind if we rest at your camp. Share your fire, after all. My comrades are weary. I need rest.
I'm sorry if I was a little tactless before. About your being a watcher. I didn't really understand what was involved. Is it hard, hearing the spirits all the time?
It's actually been fairly useful. There's no denying that the dead make for excellent sources of information, at times. sorry, at any rate, we're bound to find a solution for this. You can count on my help until we do. Why, thank you. That was good to know.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
Oh, what's this? Sea cave. Let's go back to this. What the hell is this? Cave coral? You know what the hell, let's go inside. I guess we've had found cave coral before. Not sure where it is. Thinking it might be just a small area.
Hmm.
Love how we get experience every time we find a new place. It's pretty cool. Ooh! Got more of those sporelings. Oh, and there's a dead guy there. Sporeling. Dank spore. We saw them in the catacombs, the Caprilene catacombs. Could be sort of a tough battle. Boom-sty-boom. Boom. We'll let everyone take their place. Okay. I don't want anyone to run into the fireball. Guy off. Pop a shield. All right, Theodos, just hit him. Everyone can hit him. Killed your kids. Already dead. I'm just about to move kinda closer, but alright, let's collect goodies. All the goodies, all them.
I shall.
You shall. A dead adventure. It's got green and wow. One gold. Poor guy. Hey, lockpick. Hey. One copper. Moss and mold cover the bones like a blanket. They smell earthy and wet. More cave coral. Just make sure this isn't trapped or anything.
I shall be discreet.
I mean, it shouldn't, but you never know. Oh, the secret there, though.
And the fire shows me something new.
A fine wand. A tricorn hat. Two oil. And one silver. Wow. I'm a bit underwhelmed with the treasure in this cave. An arbalest. Sheesh. Talk about your starting areas. Wow. I meant to turn that off. So... you seem to be having trouble walking. That's why I checked out that area. I knew it was going to be just a... small area. Didn't know, but I had a good idea that it would be. Oh, I'm on slow. What the hell? I'm like, I never saw him walk like that, because I don't use slow. It's not a habit of mine, games like this. I've explored a good bit of it already.
Quickly and quietly.
Yeah, slowly and carefully. Ooh, look at that huge head thingy. Ooh, wow. Well, there's nothing to look at. Let's just look down here really quick. A Zorup with spirit already. With any luck, we'll, kill him before he even gets to us. Just like the other one.
Eh?
Eh.
Brave thou philately.
It's another dead adventurer. Some more amethyst. I guess they really like that. Good taste, I gotta say. Good taste. A dead Valian. Oh, I thought it said villain for a second. A fine arbalest. And Fulvano's letter. How is it that so grand a journey as mine should lead me here? The people of the Deerwood call this pitiable legion... lagoon, a sight to see. But all I have experienced here is misfortune. I thought to explore the cavern by the waters, only to discover it was home to sporlings. I went to see the vaunted compass, and lost the bulk of my letters when I tripped over some driftwood. And at last I made to inspect the dragon skulls nearby, only to be menaced by some foolish little Zorups. I will return to Gilded Vale as soon as I catch my breath. At least the Zorups do not appear to have followed. And he actually writes dot 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 instead of defending himself right away. Silly man. Poor Fulvano. Let's complete our exploration of this area. Can't go there. Should back out a little bit. Oh, there's a dock. Is there a boat? At the center of a ring of jagged stone, this boulder casts long shadows across the sand as the sun moves ahead. A lovely sight. Would that we could have spent more time by the sea, Kenna says. You there! Did Commander Cleaver send you? How did you see us? We were sneaking. Aranroed. Aranroed.
Hail and well met.
The woman sizes you up, squinting against the glare from the water. You've come from the Crucible Keep, I take it. I was told you'd have something for me. What's your role in this? I'm a commander stationed at Fleetbreaker Castle. I was sent to retrieve the research by the High Justice himself. She leans closer. And since you know what this research is all about, you can imagine how eager I am to get it back to the castle quickly and quietly. Tell me about what's happening at Fleetbreaker Castle. Her eyes narrow, but she eventually shrugs. You're obviously helping Commander Cleaver, so I suppose I can tell you. The High Justice has been gathering forces there. This mess with the legacy, the unrest, and the man-eating corpses all over the Deerwood, it isn't going away anytime soon. And the dozens are using this as an opportunity for a power grab. We've got to build... She straightens. We've got to build up strength to defend the Deerwood as well as our position here. And with these Forge Knights at our disposal, we'll be unstoppable. All right. Here it is. Vianna's research. Excellent. I should get this back to the High Justice before... She looks over your shoulder at a sound of approaching footsteps. Too late. Get ready. Too late? Who this? Padabald? Bad enough he's bald, but he's Padabald? This man's face is twisted into a snarl. Are you mad? You hold the secrets to one of the foulest examples of animancy, and you want to hand it over to the Crucible Knights? He shakes his head. It's an abomination. Caged souls used as weapons, and you'd give these silk stockings an army of them. He raises his axe, tightening his grip around the haft. I can't let you do this. The research must be destroyed. Well, everything except for Monk, which we don't know, everything else is the same. I'd like to see you try. I'll destroy you. You'll have to get through me first. Yeah, let's just raise our weapon. Kill them all. I'm sure his response would have been the same no matter what. Alright. Unfortunately, Adair is our fighter. Mercenaries. Oh boy. Mercenary. Oh, is that a spell casting mercenary? Brother. Let's just enter combat and there we go. And I can do this. I know some of us might travel straight out of it. You know what I want to do? What I want to do here, if I have a chance to. He'll probably resist, and we can't see him anyway. Try not to hit the guy with the blue accents. We'll try to take him over, have him join our side. Should hurt a little bit for Padabald. That name, man. Can't be fun having that name. And go, man. You kill somebody already? There's blood and stuff. Oh my god. Dawn's Pledge. Circle of Protection. He's still going with that. Another. Is Padabald dead? Get him. What What about that? I guess she got interrupted. Should I try again? Can I try again? Try again. Where is she anyway? She's being interrupted left and right because someone's hitting her. Oh, she's right here in the middle of all this crap. Moderate endurance. Boom. Oh, Aranroed's helping us. Cool. Healing.
This isn't working.
And then make it work. Lay on hands yourself. This mercenary is still going. Wait a second. We're sending him after that guy. I didn't realize he was still there. I couldn't see him in the midst of everybody. Now he's dead. Everybody. Back here. Get back here, barely injured.
What?
Aranroed wipes her blade on the lining of her cape. I'll take that as our cue to leave. With the dozens growing so bold, there's no time to waste. She strides back towards the waiting boat. Give my regards to the commander, and watch her back out here. Return. She's on her way back to Fleetbreaker Castle. I should return to Crucible Keep. He will want to know that the research was delivered successfully. It's the dozens! I didn't realize it was the dozens. They were intent on keeping it from reaching Fleetbreaker Castle. Aranroed is now on her way to deliver the research. Cool. Grimoire of a Dozens Wizard. Nice. Other than that, standard stuff. An S-Dock. Bunch of S-Docks. Fine large shield. Sorted coin. Lockpick. Potion of fleet feet. That was fun. Boat went bye-bye. All the byes. The dial. Oh, cool. I didn't know that was the dial. Okay. Stay tuned for next episode when we explore the rest of Anslog's compass. I don't know. I thought I had been here. Maybe I confuse it with Magrin's fork and Slug's compass. Possibly. Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time, and endure. Enduring, go strong. I know some shanties, you know. We could have a time of it.